Dente nobis Domine misericordiam tuam.
Et salutare tuam de nobis.
Domine exalerati, exalerationem meam.
Et nobis facete
Dominus fubiscum.
Et us
oremus, exalti nos Domine Sancta Pater Omnipotens Aeterna Deus, et miterating neris Sanctum Angelum Tuum de Celis, qui custodiat, foveat, protegat, visited atque defendat, omnes habitantes in hoc habitaculo, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
David, even she's a day.
mea carcinteribus mea. Pati Filii Spiritui Sancti. Semper secula seculorum. Triva Tide. Agitorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Video de omnipotente Vate Mariae Semper Virgine Vate. Gale Alcans of the Valion of Baptiste. Sanctus Apostles Petru Apollon of the Sanctus Verbus Fratus. Cave nemis cogitatium verbo dobri. Mea culpa, maxima culpa. Deo praecor bat Mariam, Sacra Virgin, bat Michaelum, Acansum, Anum, Anum Baptista, Sanctus Apostles, Petrum, et Paulum, Omnis Sanctus, Vos Fratres, Roy, Pamea, Dominum Deum Nostrum. Thank you. Excelsis Deo. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Deus qui nos hodierna die exultatione sancte crucis annuas limitare letificas. Presta quaesimus, ut cuius mysterium interora cognovimus. Eus redemptionis premia in cielo Mary amor. Oriundum dominum nostrum Jesum Christum, filium tuum, quid convivit et regnat in unitate, Spiritus Sancti, Deus, omnia saecula saeculorum. Lectio Epistolae Beati Pauli Apostoli of Philippenses. Fratres, hoc enum sentite in vobis, quoted in Christo Jesu, qui cum in former day esset, rapinam arbitratus esse se qualum Deo, sed semet ipsum exinnivet nivet formam servia cipiens, in similitudinem hominum factus, et apitu inventus ut homo, humiliavit semet ipsu, factus obedient jusque ad mortem, mortem autem crucis, propter quod et Deus exultavit illum, et unavit illi nomen, quod est super omnem nomen. Ut in nomine Iesu, omne genuflectator, celestium, terrestrium, in infernorum, et omnes lingua confidiator, quia Dominus Iesus Christus, in gloria est Dei Patris. Dominus vobiscum. Sequentia sacte Evangelii secundum Ioannem. Nilo tempore, dixi Iesus turbus judeorum, nunc judicem est mundi, nunc princeps huius mundi efficiatur foras, et ego si exultatus furo a terra, omnia traham a me ipsum, hoc autem dicebat, significans qua morte esset moritura, responded aetorba, nos audivimus ex lege, quia Christus manet in aeternum, et commodo tu dices, apportet exultare filium homines, quis es iste filius homines, dixit ergo eius Iesus, ad hoc modicum lumen in vobis est, ambulate dum lucem abetis, et non vos tenebrae comprehendant, equi ambulat in tenebris nesce quo vada, dum lucem abetis, credite in lucem, et filii ut filii lucis sitis. Epistle for this solemnity of the exaltation of the cross is from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians. Brethren, let this mind be in you, which was also in Jesus Christ, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being made in the likeness of man, and having been found as a man. He humbled himself, becoming obedient unto death, even to the death of the cross, which cause God hath also hath exalted him, and hath given him a name which is above all names. It's okay. That in the name of Jesus every knee should bend, those that are in heaven, on earth, and under the earth, that every tongue should confess that the Lord Jesus Christ is in the glory of God the Father. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. John. At that time Jesus said to the multitudes of the Jews, "Now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the prince of this world be cast out, and I, if I be lifted up from the earth, will draw all things to myself." Now this he said, signifying what death he should die. The multitude answered him, "We have heard out of the law that Christ abideth forever. And how sayest thou, the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man?" Jesus therefore said to them, "Yet a little while, the light is among you. Walk whilst you have the light, that the darkness overtake you not. He that walketh in darkness knoweth not whither he goeth. Whilst you have the light, believe in the light, that you may be the children of light." This is the words of the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Brothers and sisters, the intention for this Mass is a special intention for Charles Larry Haight. We have today, of course, we celebrate the true cross of Jesus Christ as the instrument of our salvation. And that is not only the one time on Calvary, but it continues to be the instrument to this day. Not that he has to die in a bloody manner again, but that we have to die to the world, each of us, as members of his mystical body. It's a very interesting background to all of this. Saint Helena, back in the early 300s, was mother of Emperor Constantine, who was the first Christian emperor, as you know. She was a very accomplished woman. She was an archaeologist, and she went to the Holy Land, and she found the true cross, and she proved it was the true cross, because they found three crosses. They didn't know for sure at that moment which one was the one of Jesus. And they had a very ill woman touch two of the crosses, one after another. There was no change in her condition. When she touched the true cross, she was healed immediately. So that's how St. Helena knew which was the one true cross. She sent part of it to her son Constantine, who was in the eastern capital, the eastern empire, Constantinople, which is now called Istanbul. It's part of Turkey. She sent one part to Rome, but the greatest part of it was encased in silver. It was kept in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem. Now, a couple of hundred years later, the Persians conquered Jerusalem and took it. Took it to, the Persians would have been basically from present-day Iran, and they took it. And some time, 100 years or so after that, the Eastern Emperor Heraclius, attacked the Persians, and he defeated them this time. He recovered the true cross, still encased in silver, and he brought it back to Jerusalem. Now, when the emperor was at that time had determined, as an act of humility, he was going to, and thankfulness, he was going to carry that cross in himself into the church. And he, at some point before he got there, he stopped. He was frozen. He could not move any further. And Saint Zachary, who was the patriarch of Jerusalem, suggested to him that maybe all that imperial finery that he was wearing didn't fit the true spirit of the cross. So he took all that stuff off and just went in and just basically a tunic, I guess, and he was able to carry the cross in. There's a lot of miracles associated with it besides the miracle of salvation continuing on. So we know later on the Muslims would capture Jerusalem, they would capture the cross. And the Crusaders, after that, got motivated and came and took back Jerusalem for some time, and they, which included getting the cross back. And so at that point, or shortly thereafter, they sent it, they sent the whole thing to Rome, because I think they could see the writing on the wall as far as the Muslims. So from Rome, the greater part of the cross has been divided up. Of course, it was in very decayed condition anyway, but it's been divided up into the little tiny splinters and so forth that are in the reliquaries all around the world. And so including here in this church, we'll have a, at the end of our procession today, when we come back, we have a blessing, benediction. After that, we will have, for those who want it, the veneration of that holy relic that is usually kept here in the church. And that would, the veneration will be done by Father Willie. Doesn't think with the COVID and all we should be kissing the reliquary, but you just touch the edge of it and make the sign of the cross for those who are wish to do so. Why do I tell you all that background? Not just to fill up time, by any means. I think it's the epitome of one of the themes in Jesus' discourse today. That is, that this life is a constant struggle against the darkness. He says, the prince of the world is judged, but you got to keep doing your part. He's going to be around for a while. They used to tell me in the bureaucracy in Washington, you got to watch out for dead whales, because just when you think you're safe, that tail will flip around and get you. And it's something like that. So in the gospel, Jesus sets forth three propositions. First is the judgment of the world, as of his time of that his passion is to begin immediately after this. The prince of the world, that is Satan, would be cast out. He's saying that it determines, his crucifixion is going to determine and make it inevitable that the prince of this world is cast out. Secondly, and that he is defeated. Anything else that happens between now and the second coming of Christ is just him blustering, being reluctant to go. Secondly, Jesus, when crucified, will draw everyone to himself through the cross. That is, he will reconcile sinners to God. He will draw everyone who's willing to believe in him, I should say. Because that's the thing, when he is, thirdly, the light of the world, is Jesus Christ in this world, he's there only a short time, being among us in that way, as a man, but nonetheless, that light will shine all the way to the end of time. And the thing about it is, everybody has to make a choice. If you're not interested, you've chosen the dark side. If you are interested but you're having trouble and eventually lose in converting to him, then you're ending up on the dark side. If you come for some sick reason to hate him, you got a lot of trouble and you need to come see me about it. We'll see what we can do about that. So the light is in this world, and he's saying it's only a short time that the apostles and the disciples need to draw their strength from that light. Implicitly, he's saying, in order that it can be passed down through time. Drink it in now, guys, because it's got to be passed down to the end of time. And the church, the faithful, have done this ever since. All sin, at the root of it, is a type of idolatry. Idolatry is excessive love of the creature, created things, the self, things in the world, or people in the world, or our own agendas. It's choosing something, everything other than God is created as a creature, whether it's living or whether it's inanimate matter or whether it's alive. It's a creature created by God. And any time we love any of that more than we love God, that's idolatry. And when you think about it, that applies to sin generally. So Jesus is here signifying his triumph over idolatry. This is straight out of Abbot Guéranger from the 19th century. We know, you might say, if you translated it, you might say, we know the end of the story. We have an active part to play. It's a mystery of our free will. We must, with God's help, choose his side and bear our part in casting Satan out of the world and in adhering to the light. And of course, that starts with the self and it starts at home. And so human history goes back and forth. There'll be times where the light seems to be winning out on top, and there'll be other times in history where the darkness seems to be taken over. And yet we know the end of the story. We should not let this back and forth throw us. What is important is that each and every one of us and all those we love should belong to the light. God will take care of the rest of it. The light which is kept burning in this world through the faithful, faithful's cooperation with God, is eternal life, which we said before is a participation in the life of the Trinity, which is the light in and through Jesus Christ. This participation has already begun, or it can begin, in this life. Martin Wright say, the crucified and exalted Christ, through whom the Father's love shows, is a central point to which all will be gathered from their dispersal in sin. In this world, the holy sacrifice of the Mass embodies that same blessed crucifixion and gathering of peoples around the cross will do so to the end of the world. God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. As I mentioned, we will have a procession by way of ending the Mass. We'll go out in the same route as we did last time around, which was out here, make a circle around the parking lot closer to the road and then around the building, the parish buildings over there, and come back up on the side of the church on the sidewalk here. Once we're back in, we'll do the benediction, and that will be a Eucharistic procession, by the way. We'll do the benediction and then we'll have the veneration of the true cross for those who wish. I think that's all I need to mention. Okay. Have them come up. Yeah, at the veneration, just come up in the front pews like we do for communion. We'll bring it by there. Thank you. Vobiscum.
Thank you. saecula saeculorum.
Thank you.
digitor.
Thank you.
saecula saeculorum. Amen. Oremus. Receptus solitaris monati, et divina institutioni formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in caelis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, via voluntas tua, sicut in caelo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini in semper vobis cum. I'm used to Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, Domine nobis patrum. Domine non sum dignus. Domine non sum dignus. Domine non sum dignus. God of Est, Omnipotens Deus, Dimensis Peccatus Vestis, Peducat Vos, et Vitam Eternum. Desensum Absolutium, Mitzion Becatorum Vestrorum, Tuibot Bobis, Omnipotens Misericors, Domus. Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi. Domine non sum dignus fitus subjecta meam, sit tamne verba sit abna omnem meam. Domine non sum dignus fitus subjecta meam, sit tamne verba sit abna omnem meam. Domine non sum dignus fitus subjecta meam, sit tamne verba sit abna omnem meam. Thank you. Nomenos vobiscum. Oremus, adeste nobis Domine Deus Noster, nequos Sancte Crucis, letari facis honore, eius quoque perpetuus defendus subsidies, per Dominum Nostum, Iesum Christum, filium Tuum, quid cum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuum.
Ite missa est. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Nitium Sancte Evangelii secundum Ioannem.
Deo gratias.
Principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum. Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio apud Deum. Omnia per ipsum factus sunt, et sine ipso factum est nihil quo factum est. Ipsa vita erat, et vita erat lux hominum, and lux in tenebris luce. Et tenebra eam non comprendere. Quid homum esus Deo quidem in erat Ioannis. He venit in testimonium, et testimonium per verat illumine, et omnes crederunt per illum. Non erat ille lux, sed et testimonium per verat illumine. Erat lux vera quae illuminat omnem hominem venientem in hominem mundum. Mundo erat in mundus scripts, in factus est, in mundus eum non cum novi. In propria venit, se et sui eum non recipere. Quod adam recipere eum debit eis, potestatem filios Dei fieri his, qui credit in nomine eos. Qui non ex sanguinibus, neque ex voluntate carnis, neque ex voluntate viri, sed ex Deo nati sum. E verbum in caro factum est, et habitabit in nobis. Et vinimus glorium eos, glorium quasi unigeniti a Patre, plenum gratiae et veritatis.
Thank you. close.